Hello, Olivier. Nice to see
hello,
you.
Hello, Christopher.
How
nice
are you?
To see you.
You are in a mansion that is yours for the next weeks.
We are here at the Musée Nissim de Camondo. It's even more a townhouse than a museum itself. It's about wonderful collection of the 18th century put together at the end of the 19th century, early 20th century by an incredible man called Moïse de Camondo, who has from a Turkish Ottoman origin, and he built this wonderful townhouse in the early 20th century. And it's all about chic and elegance and the beauty of the collection. It's also about comfort and modern house. What is fantastic about the place is that when, at the end of his life, he decided to give this place to the nation. And in 1936, it opened as a museum, but nothing was really changed. And in his will, when he gave it to the Musée des Arts Décoratifs in Paris, his vision was you keep everything in place, you touch nothing.
Oh, so it's a little bit like the Gustave Moreau Museum.
Absolutely. You know, it's really, it's not an artist, but it's a collector, but it's a very close process. So here, for example, we are in the kitchen. It's like a French Downton Abbey, I would say. we know that people love Downton Abbey, but everything was organized as to be a house that the family left a few minutes ago. And the idea that I love very much is that perhaps in the 50s and 60s, people loved the Musée Nissim de Camondo because it was about French way of life and 18th century collection and so on. I think that today many of the visitors are also very, very excited by the behind the stairs.
Yeah, absolutely.
The story.
Yeah. Yeah. The back doors and the history behind it. And that, I mean, there are places like the Musée Nissim de Camondo in Paris and feel like, you know, they stayed in stuck in time, and then you can really feel the history in the walls.
Yeah, and it's something very important for our visitors, definitely. Here we are in the dining room, was obviously a very important room for Moïse de Camondo, because you know, here he was used to receive so many people, some friends, a member of great family. I mean, through his ex-wife, but also the wedding of his daughter Beatrice to the Reinach family. He was related to many great family of collector of the same level, like the Rothschild and the Caen d'Anvers and so on. So for sure, the dining room was a key place for his life. And what is interesting with the museum is this mix about, you know, museum room, as people can discover them, and some very, very domestic moments where the real life of the place took place in the 1920s, 1910s, 20s and 30s. And here, for example, you are in one of the pantry. We are just on the other side of the dining room, and you have everything here, the place to heat. Here you have the way to bring back to the kitchen the plates, and everything is waiting for the butler to be able to serve the dinner or the lunch. So that's this very, original aspect also of the Musée Nissim de Camondo that I think our visitors love very much. Here we are in the wonderful, we also opened a window for you. We are here in the small office of Moïse de Camondo. I'm not sure he was used to work that much.
For being a painting lover myself, like, I think that would be a place where I would love to just sit down and read a book, you know, maybe.
Absolutely. You have quite a comfortable and you have some incredible Francesco Guardi, a pair of painting that you have here.
Oh, the sky.
Wow. Some view of Venice.
Yeah.
And again, you know, the mix of objects all around, they are so the taste of these people in the late 19th century, early 20th century. Here we're on the second floor. It's quite a vision. The second floor is very the intimate part of the building. because really the first floor where was the dining room and the drawing rooms was really the part of the building where the family was used to receive and host friends and family. For sure, the second floor was really the private era.
So I was just wondering if you have favorite rooms in the museum, somewhere maybe you enjoy being on your own or just like read a good book.
Yeah, I would say that it's certainly one of my favorite because it's totally unknown. One room I love very much is the library I'm going to show you in a minute.
Oh my God.
It's a wonderful library. With wonderful wood paneling, which were installed, you have some quite ancient part of the paneling, and everything was installed on purpose by the architect, René Sergent, to reorganize the place. And what I love is that you feel that's a place of a collector.
Are you allowed sometimes to just pick a book and sit down and enjoy yourself?
I never do this. Sadly, but I never do this. So here you have this incredible auction catalog that's a collection of the Seligman family, was great collector but also art dealer. And I love the fact that around the library you have the Gazette des Beaux-Arts, who does not exist anymore, was really the magazine, the art magazine for the happy few, really the chic people and the great scholars all over the world who used to read this.
Would you have maybe in this library a book to recommend? I mean, I'm going to be here for a long time still, so maybe something I should get.
I mean, I, as you see, the format of the book are not really the book you want to have in bed just to, you know, to spend a good time.
A typical writer from the time, maybe. Yeah.
The wonderful Alexandre Dumas, Une vie d'artiste. You have here, which is a wonderful book. But you have also a very serious book with Luther, Sa vie et son œuvre.
Oh, wow. Okay, yeah, indeed.
By François Kuhn. I'm not sure, it's very, very lively and very funky. No, I propose you to go upstairs, somewhere where visitors are not used to go. And so we are going on the last floor, which is today partly the office floor and the team, the curatorial team floor. And it's very moving because this part of the building was the part reserved to the domesticity, but also to the, I would say, to the private life of the house, with the bedroom of the lady in charge of the linen and the bed sheets and so on. You had here's the lingerie, which is now a wonderful office. And this part of the building is absolutely not visited, but very interesting because it completed very well the fact that this place was really, I mean, a little city inside the city. And here, because the house is full of surprise, we are on the roof of the place, of the house, and you have an interesting vision on the Achille Duchesne Gardens and the Parc Monceau, which is now totally, totally empty, for sure. And the incredible roof,
yeah,
and view on the very peaceful Plaine Monceau.
That would be the place for a glass of wine with the good company.
It would be fantastic. It should be reserved to a very special tour for a very special guest of the museum to have, as you say, a piece of the cheese and
yes,
a good glass of wine or a tea party, if we want to be totally serious. And that I think that this kind of tour show you the incredible dimension of a family like the Camondo. And the fact that sometimes people don't, or visitors don't realize that a museum is not only a museum.
It's a house.
It also, you know, it's a house.
Yeah.
It's a family house. There is some spirit. There is some vibes.
Yeah, and I think what's very important, and like we said before, is that there is places in Paris, in France, where you can find the peacefulness, the history, and the art. I'm very grateful. Thank you so much for sharing that with us.
Thank you, Christopher, for this visit. It was very nice and very amusing, even for me, who know it by heart.